Welcome to Fab Monday. Today we'll talk about cloning and time travel in fabricated warehouses. Let's discover what this is. Let's talk about time travel in data warehouses. The data on a data warehouse is stored in one lake. That's what Microsoft tells to everyone, and especially true. And the storage in one lake is Delta. Delta format, using Parquet in Delta format. Parquet in Delta format allows time travel. This means that we can get the table as it was in a specific point in time, in the past. But data warehouses make their own maintenance. Different as the lake houses that we already talked about maintenance in lake houses, the data houses make their own maintenance. Why? Because they have an internal format and they synchronize the data with the one lake. This synchronization became better and better, but still it's an internal format synchronizing with the one lake. In this way, the maintenance is completely taken care by the data warehouse itself. Considering that we don't make the maintenance, this means that we don't make directly the time travel as well. If we don't make that directly the time travel as well, how can we manage it? Let's see an example. I have here a data warehouse. In this data warehouse, we have a table called Fact Sale, containing the sales on this data warehouse. And I will execute some scripts. Let's start with a query on the Fact Sale. I only get the top 10 records because this table is very big. There it is. These are the top 10 sales ordered by the sale key, and we can note the total including tax. I'll multiply the total including tax by 2. So I make an update on fetch sale, set total including tax, multiply it by 2. Let's execute. This update query took 5 minutes and 48 seconds to be executed. The Monday magic made it seem like it were only a few seconds. Now that I updated all the values from the total including tax, what happens if I would like to compare the old values with the new values? The values are updated and I was not using a transaction, so I can't go back this. How could I get the old version of these values? I can create a clone of the table. Create table, I create a new table name, fact sales past, as clone of DBO fact sale at a specific point in time. I choose the point in time. Let's do that. Execute the create. The cloning of the table took only 4 seconds to run. Only 4 seconds. Now I have the fact sale past and the current fact sale, so I can compare the values of the old total include tax and the new total include tax. Mind here the tables fact sale and fact sale past. And let's execute this query where I'm making a join between the two tables and comparing the value of the total including tax. I executed the query with top 10. So the query would be executed as, and here we can see the current and the old total include tax and the difference between them, the difference between the total include tax. In this way, we can use time travel to compare values in different moments, in different stages of our data. We can retrieve old values and make comparisons on them. This is not the most easiest way to make some analysis, but in special situations, this can be very useful. And the data house already implemented a feature to allow us clone the table using the UI. We don't need to use the SQL statements. We can use the UI to make the clone of the table. So clone table, and it asks if I would like to clone the table with the current values. I can clone a table before my update and then make the update on the table. That would be a possibility. Or if I would like to clone the table with path values, but mind the limitation within the last 7 days. Why? Why it's limited to the last 7 days? Because the vacuum statement is the statement which cleans the unlinked packet files, and in this way remove the time travel possibility. And the vacuum has a default period of 7 days, cleaning files older than 7 days. During the period of 7 days, you can make the time travel, but the data house will be running the vacuum and cleaning older data. In this way, we saw how to make the clone, how to compare the table in 2 points in time, and also notice that the data house is making some maintenance by running vacuum continuously, cleaning the data and leaving only the 7 days which are the default for the vacuum. Thank you for watching and see you next Monday.